Hi friends, today we are discussing class 10 biology based on CBSE syllabus. I hope all the schools started with the chapter 6 life processes. So I am also planning to start with the same chapter. So in this part, I am just giving an introduction to that chapter. Oru introduction mathramana ee oru partilude share cheyan udheshikkunnathu. So we can start the class. What is biology? In the broadest sense, it is the study of living organisms, or it is the science of life. What do you mean by life? Or what makes something alive? Most of you will say, living things are able to move. Okay, if we see a dog is running, a cow is chewing the cud, a man walking along the street. Okay, visible movements, we can say these all are living beings. So I am asking one thing. A car can move, a bus can move. Are they alive? No. So we cannot say if something is alive, if something is moving, it is alive. So movement is not the basic criterion to decide whether something is alive or not. So what about plants? We can't see any movement in them, but we know they are living beings. How do we understand that? They grow over time. Leaves and flowers are developing. The length of the shoot is increasing. We can't see the movement, but they grow over time. Suppose a dog is sleeping. So nammal roadilude povu opposite oru poocha allengil oru dog kedakkuva. So I am asking whether it is alive or not. So we are not sure. Sometimes it is sleeping or it is dead. So what to do next? We go there and check breathing is there or not. Breathing is there, it is alive. So breathing is also a movement, but a small scale of movement. So these are some visible movements. In addition to these visible movements, some invisible movements are happening inside the body. Example, movement of molecules. I hope you know molecules. How that molecular movement is happening inside the body? What do you mean by atoms? Atoms are the fundamental units of matter. So these atoms are joined together to form molecules. Okay. Molecules are assembled into tiny structures that are known as organelles. In your 9th standard, you have already learnt about these cell organelles, like ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes, etc., etc. These organelles are bounded in by a membrane that is a cell. Neenga manasilayina vicharikkunnu, molecular movement is happening inside the cell. So some basic processes or some basic functions are happening inside the body for the proper maintenance and survival of that organism. These processes are known as maintenance processes or life processes. Life processes, example, digestion, respiration, etc. I will explain. If we are simply sitting in the classroom, or if you are sleeping, some basic functions or processes are happening inside the body for the maintenance and survival of an organism. Example, if you are sleeping, the digestive system is working to digest the food. Respiratory system is working to convert this food into energy, ATP. Excretory system is working to remove the waste particles. Circulatory system is working to circulate the nutrients and oxygen, etc. We are simply sleeping, But some basic functions are seriously happening inside the body for the proper maintenance and survival of that organism. If these processes are not happening, the living organism cannot live. If the order of that body system is breakdown, the living organism will dead. So that is life processes. So today in this chapter, we are going to discuss the details of these life processes. For these life processes, our body needs energy. Our body needs energy. How do we get energy? You know, energy gets from food. That is the energy source. So, but this food is outside the body. That should come inside. So a process should be needed to transfer this food from outside the body to inside. So that process is what we call nutrition. Nutrition. So different types of food materials are available. Because the environment is not under the control of an individual organism. So we are getting different types of food. You know, different types of food. Chapati, meals, chicken, mutton, whatever it is. Our body should convert all these food particles into a uniform source of energy. Then only our body can utilize this energy. So for this conversion, a series of chemical reactions are happening inside the body. Oxidation reduction reactions are the most common chemical means for this breakdown. So for this ATP production, organisms need oxygen. So, but this oxygen is also outside the body. So, a process should be needed to transfer this oxygen from outside to inside. And utilizing this oxygen for the breakdown of these food particles and convert these food particles to energy. So, that process is known as respiration. So, different systems are working inside, no? Nutrition, digestion, and respiration. And this uptake of food will be the function of specific cells or tissues inside the body. But all body parts need this food. So these food particles should be transported from the source to other parts of the body. So there is a process should be needed for the transfer of these nutrients. So that process is circulation or transportation. So next system, circulatory system, in the case of plants, transportation system. Okay. As a result of all these digestion and respiration, many waste particles are formed. These waste materials are not only useless, but also it is harmful to the body. So it should be eliminated from the body. Okay. For that elimination of these waste particles, there is another system is present, that is excretory system. Okay. In this chapter, we are going to learn the details of each of these system: digestion, respiration, circulation, excretion, etc. So this is just an introduction. Okay. No, I think in your textbook, the first two pages are now we are going to study. This is another important thing. I told you that uptake of food particles, respiration, circulation, all these are happening inside the body. In the case of single cellular organisms, what do you mean by single cellular organism? The body consists of only single cell. That cell is doing all these functions, digestion, respiration, excretion, etc. Because one cell is present. In the case of multicellular organism, you know, The cells are united together to form tissues. Tissues are grouped together and perform a function that form an organ. Then many organs are joined together and perform the function that is organ system. For example, digestive system is for digestion. Respiratory system is for respiration. Excretory system is for excretion. So in the case of multicellular organism, large number of cells are present. In the case of single cellular organisms, the entire surface of that organism is in contact with the environment because their body is too simple. It is made up of only a single cell. So entire surface of that organism is in contact with the environment. So simple diffusion is enough to transfer the food and oxygen from outside the environment to inside. Understand? Because the entire surface of the organism is in contact with the environment. But in the case of multicellular organism, this simple diffusion is not enough to carry out all these functions because their body is too large, their body design is too complex, the entire surface of the organism is not completely connected or contact with the environment. So simple diffusion is not enough in the case of multicellular organism. So they are having specialized organs or organ systems are there to perform all these functions. Okay, this is very very important. The board exam question aanu pala reethiyil chodikkam. Simple diffusion is not enough in the case of multicellular organism. Why? It's a board exam question. In which you have to write down the points. The body is large, body design is complex, entire surface of the organism is not in contact with the environment, so diffusion is not enough. They need specific organ systems that you have to learn. This is very very important. But this is just an introduction of this chapter. Okay, so based on today's portions, you should learn some important questions. The first, I think in your textbook itself, four questions are there in your textbook. First question, I think, why diffusion is insufficient? Why is diffusion insufficient to meet the oxygen requirements of multicellular organism? We discussed the answer of that question. Because പല രീതിയിൽ ചോദിക്കാം. Why diffusion is insufficient to meet the oxygen requirements of multicellular organism? You can write down the points. Body is large, body design is complex, and entire surface of the body is not in contact with the environment. So diffusion is not enough. They need a special organ system. Okay. Then തിരിച്ചും ചോദിക്കാം. In unicellular organisms, diffusion is enough. Why? Because their body is so simple, it is made up of only a single cell. The entire surface of the organism is directly contact with the environment. So diffusion is enough. Diffusion, I think you know diffusion. So next question, what criteria do we use to decide whether something is alive? Now you can understand, I think many criteria are there. Not only the movement criteria, they can grow. Living organisms can grow. Living organisms can reproduce. Living organisms can respire, living organisms can utilize the energy. So different functions you can write. So what process would you consider essential for maintaining the life? That are life processes. You can write down life processes. What are outside raw materials used by an organism? So autotrophs and heterotrophs, we will study the details of this nutrition. But anyway, in the case of autotrophs, they need carbon dioxide, water. In the case of heterotrophs, they need the food synthesized by the autotrophs. Okay. But anyway, in this part, the ningala kududale focus cheyanda, you have to concentrate on this particular question. I think why is diffusion is insufficient to meet the energy requirements in multicellular organism. 5 points ഞാൻ നോട്ട് ചെയ്ത് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. കുറച്ചുകൂടെ റിപ്പീറ്റ് ചെയ്താണ്, ഇനി റിപ്പീറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നില്ല. ദാറ്റ് യു ഷുഡ് ലേൺ. അത് തിരിച്ചും ചോദിക്കാം. സിംഗിൾ സെല്ലുലാർ ഓർഗാനിസത്തിന് എങ്ങനെയാണ് അതിൻ്റെ എനർജി റിക്വയർമെൻറ്റ്സ് അത് മീറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്? ഹൗ How do they meet the energy requirements for maintaining the life of single cellular organisms? You should write down by the process of diffusion, because their body is too simple. It is made up of a single cell. The entire surface of the organism is directly contact with the environment. So direct diffusion is enough to meet the energy requirements of single cellular organism. In that way you have to write. Pine you just learn the definition of life processes. Okay, then which are the criteria do you decide whether something is alive or not, or what processes would you consider essential for maintaining the life? These are the important points. You have to remember all these important points. ഏറ്റവും ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് ആയിട്ട് ബോർഡ് എക്സാമിനൊക്കെ വന്നിട്ടുള്ള ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് നമ്മളെ പറഞ്ഞ യൂണിസെല്ലുലാർ ഓർഗാനിസത്തിലെയും മൾട്ടി സെല്ലുലാർ ഓർഗാനിസത്തിൻ്റെയും എനർജി റിക്വയർമെൻറ്റ്സ് സാറ്റിസ്ഫൈ ചെയ്യുന്ന ആ ഒരു പ്രോസസ്സാണ്. അത് നിങ്ങൾ ഏറ്റവും ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് ആയിട്ട് ഈ ഒരു പോർഷനിൽ നിന്ന് പഠിക്കുക. അതുകൂടാതെ ഇൻ അഡീഷൻ ടു ദാറ്റ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ യു ഷുഡ് ലേൺ ദ അതർ ത്രീ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ഓൾസോ. ഓക്കെ, താങ്ക് യു.